Okay, now let's talk about venous bleeding. The characteristic of venous bleeding versus arterial is that venous is dark red and oozing, whereas arterial is bright red and spurting or pulsating. But the management is going to be virtually the same. In this case, I don't see any impaled object, so I'm going to go ahead and take my 4x4 bandage and I'm going to apply direct pressure right over the laceration, the wound. I'm going to hold direct pressure and I'm going to try to control that for the next 2 to 3 minutes. In most cases, because venous bleeding is under negative pressure, it will begin to clot and stop pretty easily, unless they have a bleeding disorder or on blood thinning agents. If it does leak through, I'll take a second 4x4 or a gauze bandage, and I'll apply that as well. Now I can see that the bleeding is under control, I can actually bandage it in place. I'm going to take my roller gauze, I'm going to start at the point of the laceration, and I'm going to start to wrap this. As I wrap around her hand, I'm going to go in between the thumb and then cross it over, exactly. Cross it over right over the wound, come back around, and I'm kind of zigzagging. And then once I come through the thumb again, I'm going to cross it again. This puts just a little bit more pressure right over the bandage to hold that wound closed and to keep pressure over the wound. Now, unless this starts seeping through, we're going to be in pretty good shape. But if it does start to leak through, we're going to add more bandage and wrap it even more. Unless this patient actually is showing signs and symptoms of a life-threatening emergency, this is probably something that can be brought in by a private vehicle. But if they are pale, cool, sweaty, having trouble breathing, they lose consciousness, that's a 911 call. If the bleeding will not stop and we feel like we're losing so much that they're going into the first signs of shock, that's a 911 call. But in most cases, especially when it's a venous bleed, it's easy to control and get them back on track.